My name is Anil sir. I'm from McLean, McLean India Private Limited, and we are taking care of all this other segments like hotel industry, especially we are in the five-star Bangalore, and as well as the IT group, pharma, and entertainment centers. All the locations we have present in 13 cities in India. Mm-hmm. We have been taking care of all the leading companies as well. Mm-hmm.
Just to add what Anil has shared. I'm also from McLean. McLean is a 16-year-old company. We have 6,000 headcount. We are operational and two have been added. So 15 is the locations where we are present in as of now. We have a multi-industry exposure. We deal with the hospitals, we deal with IT sector, we deal with all the five-star properties of Taj, wherever they are there, we are in. So most of the properties of Google's, of the world, Tech Mahindra, DCS, we take care. Apart from that, we are associated with the municipalities, out of the GHMC is one. We give our services to them. For the past 2 years, GHMC is taking our service. We are slowly moving towards IT plus operations put together. That's where we are coming up with the user management system onto the web. So that's what we are in, and thank you so much for inviting us.
So myself, I am representing Abita Services Private Limited. I am head of pest control and a division called Home Run. So we are basically into B2B, into all sort of services, right from house cleaning to mechanical engineering service, catering, security, all those stuff we are doing. And we have about 44,000 employees is our own. To name any city, metro, we are present across India. We are 30 years experience in the market. This is what all about UDS.
My name is Arjun Mundaya, Chief Mechanical Engineer. Basically, we are a technical department. We maintain the rolling stock, and coaches, wagons, and memo services, demo services, all having this passenger interface areas. And 1 year back, we have set up the environment and the housekeeping wings. So now that is a separate independent wing. Apart from the technical area, we are dealing. And they are purely in the activities related to maintenance of this coaches, passenger coaches, the stations, we call this T1 and T-class coaches, the stations, the complete, and then the we provide through the outsourcing, the cleaning guy, persons to travel all up to the destinations, do all the cleaning job there, come back. We have this clean train stations. We have nominated stations where the gangs are already there. And the moment a train comes there and has a halt of 10 to 15 minutes, the persons go up on this coaches and do this cleaning. In-route cleaning is done at some stations. So the work, the volume wise is quite heavy, I would say, quite happy. So this is what we are, and we requested the ma'am that if we are able to meet some of these facilities providers, service providers, who are dealing in a bigger manner.
We are in Chandigarh, Ludhiana, Jalandhar, Amritsar, and Mohali. Mohali has been awarded also. We've got about 5 awards for creating a benchmark in road sweeping. Okay. And washroom hygiene, of course, is a one-stop solution for washrooms. Then we have line services, which is the facility management arm of the company. So they can give you complete...
Let them complete their
I am Isi Sharma from All Services Global Private Limited, and she is our branch manager.
All services is
onboard housekeeping services for railways. And we are also doing a lot of stations, like in Hyderabad, Kajigoda, Secunderabad, various other stations. So our
He is based at our railroad office. He is a AK Tiwari and advisor housekeeping and
environment
and housekeeping. So centrally he is looking after the entire Indian Railways as far as this. So all policy decisions is under his area.
So now,
anybody
want
to
tell, or do you want to
play
the specific
I think,
program?
Such a small crowd, we can interact, take it forward as things go. Thank you, Arjun. As he said, I'm Alok Tiwari. I'm advisor, environment and housekeeping management at Ministry of Railways, Railway Board. Purpose of coming here, if I can be frank, is Madam, she met our minister and requested him for inauguration. This was not in the agenda, so there is nothing prepared. But then when Madam suggested we can have a round table with you all yesterday we had with laundry people there, I had some specific issues also. I thought, why not, let me listen to you on what you propose for our sort of problems. And maybe we are trying to develop some draft policy on this regard, wherein we will have some more detailed work specification also, and also the work measurement, payment, penalty, all those kind of issues. Once we have some kind of a draft agreement or draft documents, then we may call you all for a meeting in board so that you can give your inputs, because ultimately you are the one who have to do the work. So we don't want to make something or specify something which is not acceptable to you. So it has to be acceptable to you, it has to be acceptable to us. These are some of the issues. Coming back to specifics, as Arjun has already said, currently the housekeeping activities are too fragmented. First of all, we have station cleaning, then we have depot cleaning, then we have cleaning of coaches in the depot, then we have onboard housekeeping services, which is a misnomer in the sense it's only the cleaning services which are currently being provided. We would like to increase the scope. Then we have pest and rodent control of coaches, of station area, of our coaching depot. All these are separate activities. As a result, what is also happening is a typical my field officer who is in charge of a coaching depot, looking after the maintenance of coaches, he supervises something like 23, 24, 25 contracts. So for a person to monitor 25 contracts is impossible, in the sense that he is busy doing contracts only and he is not able to devote time in monitoring quality of the contract. So we would like to consolidate the work. We would also like to enter into relatively longer term relationship, maybe at least 3 years if not 5 years, so that you also know that you are also in this business for a long time and you also develop a stake. So these are some thought processes which are currently on. We would be specifying them in our documents, and we would like you all to be our equal partner in providing better services to the customers. With this, now some of you are dealing with railways, so I think maybe those who are dealing are the better start points, because then you are immediately there, you can provide the inputs. Subsequently, those who are not there as of now can contribute, I suppose.
And like Mrs. All Services Global Limited, you are already in this activity.
So my
point is that we hardly get such occasions. Today you are here, and like from Railway Board is there.
No, as of now, there is a system that there are some tenders, we bid for it, and if we happen to be
something new, what based on the experience you already have with the railways. So, what is the more you can suggest?
One of my suggestion is that since there is a lot of investment in the machines, like scrubbing machines, vacuuming and all. So the minimum contract period there should be 4 years at least. Means in the tenders, many stations should be included of one particular area. So that when we vote for this, you know, we are mentally ready to invest also and organize the labor also. And you are telling about this quality of the services. Our company is also associated with DDKU, that is Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Skill Development Program. So we have trained some more than 15,000 people in Odisha, UP, Ahmedabad and Gujarat areas. So these people we induct after training. So people are skilled. So we are capable of providing the quality services. As such, since we have completed a lot of contracts with railways, so I need not explain much on my company's capability. The company is capable. As such, we are having something like 12,000 people on our rolls, 400 contracts we are executing all over India. All the best hospitals in India we do, in AP all the government hospitals we are doing. Mumbai Metro we are doing for the last 3 years. And in case if you have seen Mumbai Metro, you know, people are very appreciative of our services. Delhi Metro also we have done some 3-4 stations, Rajiv Gandhi stations and all Kashmiri Gate. So as a company we are fully capable of, you know, taking major portion of your business of any particular region.
No,
on pan India basis.
I always have some kind of a perception as far as our, I mean this, the way our contracts are working. So I'm familiar with this 5-star culture where this very high standard of cleanliness is maintained. At the same time, when I compare my own activity centers, sometimes I start doubting whether I am being given the inferior kind of manpower who do not understand what is the cleanliness standards. Because this is basically, unless somebody perceives a certain level of the standard to be achieved.
No, we will tell you what is the benchmarks. A particular person who is of so and so a particular age minimum and he is educated to by so and so standards minimum and then he has undergone so many months of training, then only he will be deployed. So we will give you that benchmark below which the people will not be deployed in your sites. So that kind of commitments can be given for each and every person, whether it is a supervisor or a housekeeper or a facade cleaner or onboard housekeeping boy.
Somehow, what I have seen is the once the contract is given, then the manpower somehow they are not remaining there permanently. There is a continuous
cleaning is a job for which unfortunately
that is really affecting.
They don't like to do. So there is a very high level of mobility.
That is one of the reasons that now this the contractual workers today have to be paid all the insurance, the PF and all other things. Perhaps I think I find that that portion is not being taken care of, and as a result they become disappointed and then they leave. And that in turn is...
It is now online system, we are fully compliant and we give you the challenge, that is the e-challenge for all the people who use the ESIC.
So this is one of these reasons which is...
ESIC number, PF number is...
This problem is not only for the railways, everywhere we are facing this attrition. Very high attrition in this and rotation. Housekeeping companies themselves rotate.
Motivation can only keep them.
Why do you say 4 years as the minimum period?
Because there are some machines like scrubbing machines and all, they cost a little more. 3 lakh rupees, 4 lakh rupees, and some.
The amortization price, what they have been quoting. So amortization, it would be 3 lakh rupees.
So if amortization period is 36 months, the cost goes up. We take it at something like 42 months, 48 months, then the cost also comes a little lower.
So that will be there. The longer the period, the lesser will be the proportionate cost of the equipment.
The equipment is, of course, more than necessary because so much of area of station or outside the station and in the trains also, some kind of a machines will definitely be required. It cannot be totally manual things.
For example, so, in Secunderabad railway station itself, we are operating nearly 41 machines.
I'm quite happy to announce that today, I think Secunderabad station is one of the best maintained stations in Indian Railways.
In Mumbai also, Mumbai Central has been announced as one of the best kept stations out of 75 or something.
We are, from board level, we are going to, we already conducted a survey of various stations as regarding the cleanliness. Mm-hmm. That you are in the business, so you would be aware. We do intend to carry out another repeat audit. This is information for you also.
Yeah.
We do intend to carry out a repeat audit of the stations. And it would not be an audit, it would also be a kind of a survey which we intend to undertake every 6 months from railway board level.
You will find our company everywhere, sir.
Good for you, but the point is that we would be repeating this in a way to not basically for ranking purposes, although we call it ranking, but more as an encouragement, recognition of those people who are doing
you
well could, and providing a motivation.
You could introduce some rewards also.
There's a reward which is already introduced for the environment.
Allow me an interruption of 30 seconds. I'll just read out some name of the station. Nampally, Secunderabad, Hyderabad, Kalba, Kurla, Sanpada, CST, Chennai, Bandra Terminus, Surat, Mumbai Central, Vadodara.
Kurla, if you are able to improve, you can improve anything.
Kurla, I did the survey myself and I know, sir.
I have spent 8 years on Central Railway. I was ADRM on Central
Railway. You have to take a handkerchief
so
and
if you have,
more than
if
5 minutes
you
can't
improve Kurla, you can do all the stations.
Yes, we are doing that, sir.
Madam is in from Bombay only, she will also, I don't know whether she has ever
been to... No, I don't go, I'm a railway person.
No, Kurla, you would only be going in case you are taking a long distance train. It is ITT actually, not Kurla. You are doing ITT or Kurla?
Kurla.
Kurla is Sabalwan, that is also difficult, but ITT is even more difficult. ITT you are not doing.
ITT actually, I did the survey myself, but then somehow, probably...
I think ITT you had the contract. 2005-2007 you had the contract.
Yeah, actually long time.
2005-2007. Yeah. That time it was not satisfactory. No. I was ADRM at that time. So I think you also must have evolved over a period of time, I suppose. But
I am the CEO for Washroom Hygiene Concepts. This is part of the Global Excellence Group. We are into facility management.
So
we are
already
spoke about it.
If you can provide some inputs on whatever I have already said, or maybe something more, what
definitely
what would facilitate you to get into this business? Because we would like
we can give you a total solution. We can give you a total solution, and we believe in training. Training is the key to success of all these products, and we have our people. If we give you N number of people, we will make sure that they stay on site. Unless they go on leave and then replacements are sent. That is one of our policies of the company.
How do you propose to ensure that the staff which has been deputed remains at work and delivers the work?
We do surprise audits, sir.
No, this is for everyone actually.
Yeah, we do surprise audits and we are very, very strict about the work being delivered properly. And we give training also. At every level, training is given.
Because static cleaning, static cleaning, again, I mean the stations or coaching depot and all, it is entirely different as compared to the onboard. Onboard, unfortunately, we are not able to provide accommodation because we are not able to provide accommodation to our customers. So we are not able to reserve accommodation for your staff who goes there. So the working conditions are tough, but we have also been finding that the service providers have also been involved in cutting corners in the sense at the beginning the attendance is marked, so all number of prescribed number of people will be there because the train is going, so it is ensured that they also board the train, but they would board the train at Mumbai Central and get down at Borivali, for example. Then there would be another set who will be boarding somewhere close to Delhi and marking their attendance in Delhi. 5% boarded here, 5% disembarked there, full attendance in between service zero. So these are the kind of things which have been happening. So some railways have done something from South Central. He has done a geotag, the photograph system that at various prescribed locations, the employees who are supposed to be going are supposed to get themselves photographed. Those photographs are uploaded so that you know that the person is there. But we would like this
from
also to be.
Barcode system also been placed, like barcodes in every one of them should be get a barcode kind of thing.
See, we don't want to unnecessarily complicated things also, and we don't want to put a policeman over a policeman over a policeman because all this adds to the cost. So we would like you all, basically we would like you all to leverage technology to assure you that your person is there, and in turn assure us also that the person who is going, say for example a biometric kind of attendance system can be built in the part of the contract for the traveling
particular.
So that the system logs in the attendance automatically. You also know once you are paying for a person to go, I am sure you will make sure that he also.
Yes, of course.
Because your saving is the person not
there. The person is there, whether they are doing or not, it's contractor's job because they have been outsourced the contract.
Biometric is the, one of the best tested methods.
We also have other equipment like hygiene monitors, which monitors whether the cleaning is being done or not. And we also have footfall monitors and things like that. There's so many things coming up now. So we use the latest and best of equipment also to make sure that the work is done properly. We train them also to ensure that they do a proper job. And replacement staff is always on readily kept. So in case somebody is on leave, we replace immediately.
No, strict supervision is required for all these services because it is the supervisor who will get the work done. Because we cannot control 10 people working in a day.
You cannot
can
be voting policeman over policeman.
Yes, so one supervisor is the person who will be responsible to us, and in turn all those people working in particular site will be responsible to the supervisor. And it is the supervisor who gets the work done.
So again, coming back to it, what you would like us to do so that you get interested in this business?
We are already enlisted.
We definitely would like to be a part of this. It is a very, very challenging, and with the kind of new products that we have. For instance, we would propose instead of liquid soap creates a lot of growth of bacteria. So instead of that, we would give you hard soap, which can be come out in form of dust. You know, those kind of innovative things we can give you. So this is a new product which has come from Germany that we have just got involved in. So it grates the soap and gives you greater granules of the soap. So that is, the wastage is less. So those kind of innovative products. And training, as I told you, is our key to success. So we firmly believe in training our staff at every level. And also, the same staff would definitely continue on site, and when unexpectedly if somebody has to take leave, we will have a replacement team in place.
Okay, let me rephrase my question then, because I have still not got the answer to this. If it is like this, then why are you not with railways?
Knowing well that
what is your problem? Why are you not with
UDS?
I
want UDS transfer with 50,000 manpower.
And why are you not with railways?
Actually, we are.
What is holding you back?
We are with the railways, and some of the CMRL station, or even most of the Hyderabad station, it's under our control. But coming to your point, you want solution, right? So what sort of action we are going to take? See, for example, many of the railway tender. It is based on manpower and the screening letter. Means it is related to the number of manpower and the area.
Yeah, yeah.
So instead of that, why don't you give an SLA based tender?
Yeah, that is the main thing.
So that means you are clear. End of the day, I have to deliver what you want, irrespective of manpower X, Y, Z, whatever it may be. Then if you give the SLA, I can put 100 manpower or 50 manpower. End of the day, I need to give the best result. That is one.
If so, I can, before I forget your other points, I hope you don't forget your other points, is that the problem with SLA-based tender is measurement. How do I measure the quality delivery?
He says.
Anyway, you have summarized your problems. One is the training, another one is the quality, and the scope of work. And various vendors. So UDL is the one-stop solution for you. We have our own, you know, everyone has, but what is speciality in UDL? We have a foundation, UDS Foundation. Under UDS Foundation, there is a training academy. That academy is approved by Ministry of Skill Development. Whoever is, you know, under our employee, they're properly certified. After that only, you know, they on board. So that certification we are spending. For each and every employee, we are spending about 2,000 rupees to get a certificate. And the certificate, there are, you know, two steps. One is they will, you know, properly trained by in-house team, that is through our UDS Foundation. And the second one is someone from, you know, central government, he will assess. Once it's get enough past certificate, then only, you know, we can.
Yanni, 1 minute. Before you talk about UDS capabilities, he is asking, what is that you expect from the railways? You know, why you are, so one you said that the SLA based one.
Yeah.
And then if you could list that out,
yeah,
and then
yeah,
we will and come back to the next. One is, yeah.
One you said that.
Then you said that. Then he can answer that.
Maybe that you are afraid of this bureaucratic setup, and that is likely to slow your way. So that kind of that kind of perception.
Yeah. See, one is this, and what is the second point?
Second, in terms of what, why we are not in
India. Why you are, why this marriage is not taking place?
No, see, there's nothing to stop us. See, we are everywhere, so not
then
why
are
you?
it's because of, you know, maybe, you know, this equipment cost we'll have to bear. Okay, that is some sort of decision because the investment is huge. End of the day, no, we are here to get some money out of it. Providing, you know,
I agree with that.
Okay, so that is the one. See, it doesn't mean that, no, you are giving the tender and we are bidding all those stuff. If we are getting some money out of it, is definitely we will be there. If the cost is not worth, then what is the point? That is another way we have to look it out in terms of the costing. And I don't think so other...
You see, the costing is again depends upon all of you who are sitting here. We have made certain estimates. Estimates are manpower based, I agree. We can think of how to make it performance based or output based. But measurement of output always remains an issue. One of your colleague only will give a lesser quotation and then try to cut corners or try to do something or maybe deliver also. You don't know how do I eliminate, let's say this is the qualified bidders who are participating in the tender and they have quoted again no offenses intended or no nothing,
no.
They have quoted lesser, so how do I overrule
correct, sir.
So as far as price competition is there, you will have to compete. I agree with that. If it is not suiting your business requirement, like Bombay mein jaise kehte hai padta nahi padta, to aap nahi loge. So if it does not suit the business, does not suit you, it does not give you enough margin, you will not take it. I understand that. You will not go below a certain limit. But the fact will remain is that if somebody who is also, let us say, equivalent, quotes a lesser limit, he will get the work.
Correct.
He will get the tender. Because this is how...
But that is how the system works, sir. For example, I'll give you one, the best example. You take, you know, any sort of hospitality industry, so without pest control they can't, okay? So in India, there's the best or named company in India, so like PCI, Rentokil, Highcare. So if the, you know, hospitality industry is the best, then they will have to take the best company in pest control, right? Nowadays, both the industries not sync. Why? Because hospitality is the industry, they're expecting their vendor to, you know, reduce the cost. If I reduce the cost, I can't give you the better quality. You take, you know, any five-star hotels, they are not associated with the top pest control company in India. Why? If I am the pest control company.
The same reason why I will not associate with the top hospitality service provider.
No, see, if you because need a quality...
Ultimately, you see, like, if they pay more to the pest control agency, their own margins get affected. unless they are able to get those kind of margins. So it is the same problem. The problem which I am facing, the same problem you are facing in case you are subcontracting. So leave aside that, because that is something which all of us have to deal with. You have to deal with your
competitors. Because pricing is get affected, right?
The pricing is something which we have to deal with. So leave aside that. One is, so far you said basically one thing, that is the manpower based versus the output SLA based or output based tender. Anything else?
Presently we are doing GHMCC. Though we are 16 years old, since 2 years we are associated with the government organization. The only hunch we have is the day we cut the invoice to the day we realize the amounts, right? It takes huge amount of time. That's one reason which keeps us aside from the government, which you ask, why didn't you try for the right way? That's one of the reasons.
Again, I will reply to that, see, government organization is a government organization. They work in a certain way, they work in a certain way. So, when you are participating in the tender, you know these time periods, or you know these delays, or you know these factors.
Correct.
So, I suppose all of you are factoring in the time value of money in your pricing calculations.
But generally what happens?
So, if you expect payment with a bigger age, even in private sector, you don't get payment easily. You work for Reliance, you will not get payment.
I am with Reliance from almost 7 years and I get my payments at 15 to 20 days. Once the papers are submitted. 15 to 20 days in the account.
We have a time frame of 45 days, but it comes within
30
days.
But
even
the
lucky is there. I'm working with the Anil Ambani Group as well as the Mukesh Ambani Group.
There is some delay. Each setup will have certain processing time, certain delay. Chief Mechanical Engineer on NF Railway. So any new vendor coming in, I was advising them to put their first bill as early as possible.
Sure.
Because the first bill will get delayed because of various procedures and processes or whatever it is. But once you are through the process once, you know what it requires for you to enable faster delivery.
Now the reason why I...
What also happens is that you feel that it is too small a bill, why should I pay, let something accumulate and then do... And then you get into delays. And then it increases the cost to you. Because I understand that there is a time value of money.
What I understand from you is at the advisory board level, if you are looking at, the two one. One is at the planning level, the other one is at the execution level. Execution level is where we are placed. Planning level is where you are in. So if as an outsider, if I look at a planning guy who is designing the entire thing, it should be more lucrative. Anyone would say that I would like to have more pie. That's it's anyway because 5% to 10% I'm in. So he will say he'll go on bid. The other one is the motivation levels of the implementation guy will look for a longer run, as I said, from 1 to 4 years. Apart from that, the guys who actually go and do the job there, they need to be a part of the team. In the sense that if there are hundreds of people I hire in and I give a training of my own, which I don't know are the standards of the railways, I give them as per some book or as per our requirement or as per my previous knowledge. I give them those knowledge. But what happens is if that guy is getting 10,000, he'll move somebody giving 11,000. 1,000 makes a lot of difference for him. 30% is the turnover of the people in this industry. The guy, 100 people I hired, 30 people move out from here to here and here to here. That's the basic problem. How do I make them to stay with me? Means I have to show him a bigger picture. I have to show him a longer run. For that, we require your help in terms of training them on your personal thing, maybe giving them a lucrative saying that you stay with this company for 5 years, whoever does well, maybe given a chance to work with you, I don't know. With those things will help.